Okay, good morning, everyone. Welcome to our 2014 NCCAM Integrative Medicine Lecture Series. It's my pleasure to welcome Dr. Bill Gurley, who is our first speaker in this 2014 series. Dr. Gurley is a professor in the Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Director of the Clinical Pharmacokinetics Laboratory at the University of Arkansas for Medical Sciences College of Pharmacy. He's also Chief Science Officer for BOM Scientific Innovations, an incubator company for the university as well. Dr. Gurley's NIH-funded research focuses on herb-drug interactions, a very important area for NCCAM, as we've been having lots of discussions over the last, actually, couple of years on this topic. And he's an internationally recognized expert in the area of botanical dietary supplements and the effects on human drug metabolism and disposition. His specific research interests include phytochemical-mediated modulation of human drug metabolism and transport, pharmaceutical aspects of botanical dosage forms, and assessment of dietary supplement safety and efficacy, all extremely important issues for our mission at NCCAM. His research has resulted in more than 150 publications and abstracts, and since 2000, he has given more than 100. 1,000 would have been too much. Invited lectures on various aspects of botanical supplement safety to both public and professional audiences. Today, Dr. Gurley will provide an historic overview of herb-drug interactions, discuss their mechanisms using clinically relevant examples, and examine prospects for further research in this area. So please welcome Dr. Gurley.
Thank you, David, for such a nice introduction. It's indeed a pleasure for me to speak to NCCAM this morning. A lot of familiar faces in the audience, and I greatly appreciate the opportunity. Of course, most of you don't know me, but my laboratory was a veteran, as I like to call it, a veteran of the ephedra wars back in the day, and since that time it's been involved in conducting prospective clinical trials to assess the potential for various botanical dietary supplements to modulate human drug metabolism. And so most of that data over the last 18 years I'm going to kind of use as for the basis of this talk this morning. So now, of course, we're all well aware that plants have been a source of drugs since time immemorial. But the issue of herb-drug interactions really didn't come to the forefront until after the Second World War, when drugs moved from multi-component plant-based preparations to purified single-ingredient synthetic drug compounds. All right? And if one delves into the medical literature, it's pretty obvious that phytochemicals have been recognized for their ability to modulate the activity of conventional drug metabolism for many decades. Now, one interaction that's often described in the medical literature is the ability of phytochemicals, particularly those present in cruciferous vegetables like the isothiocyanates, to modulate certain drug metabolizing enzymes and thus the pharmacokinetics of a variety of drugs. And of course, the ability of cruciferous vegetables to modulate human drug metabolism is actually a good thing. It's probably from more of a chemopreventative aspect. But the concern for herb-drug interactions really didn't come into its own until around 1991, and that was the year that grapefruit juice kind of took everybody by surprise for its ability to increase the oral absorption of many drugs and possibly their toxicity. And then soon after the grapefruit juice issue came to light, the Dietary Supplement Health and Education Act was passed, and a plethora of unique phytochemicals became available for consumption in the United States in the form of botanical dietary supplements. Now, the real issue of herb-drug interactions, at least from my perspective, really didn't come into its own until around 1998, when an article was published in the Journal of the American Medical Association, and the article dealt with alternative medicine use in the United States. And in the article, the authors estimated that in 1997, 15 million adults took prescription medications concurrently with herbal remedies or high-dose vitamins, which is about 18% of all prescription users based on that study. They also went on in the article to estimate that nearly 3 million adults aged 65 years or older were also taking conventional medications concurrently with herbal remedies. And so, because the elderly are our greatest consumers of conventional medications, then they may be at an increased risk for herb-drug interactions. And of course, since that time, a wide variety of surveys have appeared in the medical literature indicating that, at least I've always found this statistic quite interesting, that between 30 and 60% of hospital patients use botanical supplements on a regular basis. And of course, a number of other surveys kind of corroborate that initial survey that came out in JAMA. About 20 to 30% of all prescription drug users take botanical supplements on a regular basis. What's even more interesting is that about 70% of all supplement users also take prescription medications. So there's certainly a likelihood for herb-drug interactions to occur. And I think one of the most important statistics for healthcare providers to understand is that less than 40% of patients ever reveal the fact that they're taking a botanical supplement to a healthcare professional. So that's all. Oftentimes you literally have to pull it out of them. Now, another study that came out, in 2001, I believe, that also kind of caught a lot of, particularly the medical community, not necessarily the pharmacy community or the alternative medicine community, but the allopaths of the world. And it was a study that was done by the Department of Anesthesiology at Texas Tech Medical Branch in Lubbock. And what they did is they surveyed a little over 1,000 patients just prior to going into surgery for their use of alternative medicines. And what wasn't that surprising that most of them were using vitamins. No big deal there. But what was quite surprising to them was the number of patients that were actually using garlic and ginkgo and St. John's were pretty substantial percentages. And as we'll talk about, many of these, or at least a few of these, can cause some significant herb-drug interactions. And so that in itself kind of was a quite an eye-opening finding for the medical community.